We're here with Jimmy Wallhead at the Power Base in Loughborough. Before we talk about, you know, Bellator, BAMMA, and all the other things, we just watched you do training session here with a lot of. How much do you enjoy those sessions, and you know, why do them? Is this sort of money in the pocket, or
money in the pocket, man. I mean, I live just down the road, and I've been here 2 terms now, or 2 years, and it's money in my pocket, but I fully enjoy it as well. You know, I mean, it's nice to see some of the guys come in and never done nothing, and. Yeah, to see him improve over the time, training me. So yeah, I get a nice reward out of it. I enjoy doing it, and it certainly helps fund my own training. So yeah,
because I was talking to a few of the guys a second ago, asking them how it went, and one of the things they said is you spend a lot of time giving real constructive criticism to the. Does that help you as a fighter? Does it make you examine your own game?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, that's why I like coaching, because. I mean, there's always something you forget, do you know what I mean? And whilst you're coaching, you cover so much, because they're all different levels and stuff. You're always, you know, remembering things you haven't done for a bit, and makes you really concentrate about your technique. That's why I like coaching. I get back from it as well, you know?
That's good. And again, talking to the students, they thoroughly enjoyed it.
Yeah.
Now we go on to perhaps unpleasant business, I suppose. The contract with Bellator is now finished. Yeah. And, you know, I think that was an up and down experience for you. I think it's fair to say. What have you taken from it? What are the positives you've taken from the experience? Surely you've learned something.
Yes, there's a few.
Is there anything you can say?
Okay. There's a few positives. I don't know. I mean, there's not many.
No.
But there's a few. Obviously, just being in them high-profile fights, I fought guys who won the tournaments and stuff, and the ex-champions, and I know I lost, and I don't think I performed them fights to my fullest. Not saying I would have won, but just, I don't know, a bit more belief in myself. I don't think I can ever get out phasey. I think the reason I lost them fights was more psychological than physical, partly because, you know, I think I've grown mentally from it. I think that's the main thing that I can say I've grown from the whole experience. I know now I can, whoever I fight, and I fought tall guys, I fought short guys, I fought big guys, small guys, strikers, wrestlers. I think now it doesn't make really any difference to me now, psychologically. I think I'm a lot more at ease with myself and my opponent, and a lot more stronger minded.
You know, you said it yourself just a second ago, your last fight against Good, you just didn't seem quite yourself. And was there any reason for that? There's a rumor mill saying that you were ill, and that you weren't allowed to get the medical support you needed, or you weren't allowed to get hydrated.
I don't want to make excuses, because Lyman's very good and he fought a very good fight, and you know, he won fair and square, no question about it. I think I could have done more. If I even was my best, would I have won? I don't know, he's a big strong guy. But without making excuses, long story short, I fucked up my rehydration after the weigh-in the night before. Weigh-ins were quite late. After the weigh-in, tried a different way of rehydrating. I don't know why I did. And basically, I was in this restaurant, just about to sit down, have the first meal. My stomach like really expanded. Started feeling like real bad. And I know how bad it is to be sick after you rehydrate, because you're already low on all your minerals. So I was like, don't be sick. I couldn't hold it. Ran to the toilet. Blah, got real bad. Everything that I drunk went back up. And then within literally a few minutes, my hands went into like spasms. My back muscles cramped up. Good job I had no food in my belly, because I would have probably pooed myself. I was like constantly weird, man. Like my body shut down. Yeah. It went weird. So we had to go to hospital and have an IV. And it was just,
you know, hardly ideal.
Like,
before
it was like 4 hours like that. You know, before I was sorted, it just weren't the best. Really, I think in the fight I felt good in my cardio. Even though Lyman was big and strong, I didn't feel as strong as I know I am. Even at my strongest, I would never have out-muscled Lyman. No, he was a very strong guy, but yeah, I didn't feel 100%. But I can't think of any fight I really have been 100%. So without making, you know.
Yeah.
So no, I don't want to make excuses, because he's a wicked fighter and a nice lad as well. So.
I only asked the question because Jimmy.
Yeah, I messed it up. I have not ever travelled and got it right. Even the Ryan Thomas fight, I'll open say I travel shit. I travel and fight absolutely shit, and it's something I'm learning, and I feel now. Again, after this, like another mistake, I think now I know now. It's all learning, isn't it? You learn every day in life doing anything, and I'm learning all the time in fighting. And it's not just about the fighting, though. It's not just about the training, it's about the food, you know, being comfortable on your travel. I don't like being away from my missus and kids for long as well. So many factors, that affects me mentally a bit, whatever. Yeah. Excuses over.
Well, Bellator's now in the past, and you've got the main event at BAMMA 12 in Newcastle. Are there any details to this BAMMA contract? Is this one fight? Is it eight fights? Is it?
I think it's going to be four. I haven't signed anything yet, so it's not all official. But yeah, we're aiming for like four fight deal.
And are you looking for that over a period of time? As in, sort of, you'd like four fights, 18 months,
as opposed to 3 years? Yeah, like I say. I don't know, small print, but yeah, somewhere along them sort of lines.
How busy do you want to be? 2013?
Yeah, I'd like to fight four times this year. I'd like to. I look back in my career, I'm sure I fought eight times 1 year, seven times. Do you know what I mean? Four or five times. Yeah, I want to make some money. You know, you keep. With Bellator, I fought once a year for 3 years. Yeah. I'm not going to be at my best. Do you know what I mean? You need to be fighting, and I want to be fighting, and hopefully, a bit of luck this year, I can get, 100% free. I'd be very happy with four fights.
Well, your last two BAMMA appearances were what some people would consider the upset over Frank Trigg at middleweight, and then of course the incredible knockout of the night against Villasenor. How pleased you'd be back at BAMMA?
Over me. It's where I wanted to be since them fights, really. Yeah, I didn't, that pussyfooting around. I didn't really want to go back to Bellator. I wanted to stay with BAMMA. I felt like I was getting some good momentum there. Contention of title shots and stuff, and just them experiences and then wins in front of the crowd. It was Birmingham and Nottingham, so there's a lot of people there supporting me as well. And it just don't compare fighting in America to fighting here. For me, fighting from the British fans is the best feeling in the world, and I'm just looking forward to doing that again.
And of course, the opponent they've announced at Matt Veach. What do you know about Veach other than his UFC appearances? Is there anything?
Yeah, well, obviously he's from Hit Squad, so he's got world class training partners and stuff. I've watched some of his conditioning stuff. He's a fit, strong guy. I'm sure he's going to come in big at welterweight as well. I know he's fought a lightweight, but he obviously cuts a lot of weight to get to lightweight. So I think he's going to come in like around 83, 84 kilos. I'd imagine maybe a bit more. I don't know how big he is. So he's going to come in big, strong. Yeah, he's a pretty amazing wrestler, really. He's got a great shot, good control, a couple of cheeky subs and stuff. I think he poses a lot of problems. He's a bit swingy as well. He's got power in his hands, he's not the smoothest of boxers, but he can certainly knock a man out. So
does the size matter? The fact that this guy is, he's a natural lightweight, that's where he cuts his weight to fight. Does that make a difference in terms of expectation? Oh, you're the bigger guy, you should win. Does that bother you?
Maybe people think that. It doesn't make a difference in my head, I don't think, because he's a lightweight, I should thrash him. He's a UFC veteran, he's fought great opponents in the UFC and out of the UFC, he's fought good guys as well. He's a world-class wrestler. Even in the UFC, everyone said he's one of the strongest lightweight wrestlers. He poses problems, He poses a lot of problems, and he's going to come in big and strong. He won't take the fight at welterweight if he was walking around at 76 kilos or 75 kilos. He's probably 85 kilos in the States now. So he's going to come in big.
Obviously, fighters don't like to talk about game plans, so I'm not going to ask about yours, but what do you think Veach's will be for you? How do you think he wins this fight?
Well, I think he's going to wrestle. Because he is a wrestler. I'm sure he's going to have the confidence to stand as well. Like a fight anyone, you're going to expect everything. But I know his wrestling is stronger than his striking. If he wants to stand and strike and not wrestle, sound. If he wants to wrestle, cool. But I'm the same. I'm not just going to go in there and strike. I'm going to put an MMA fight in. I'm going to strike and I'm going to take him down. I'm going to put pressure on him. It's an MMA fight. If the openings are there for me, I'm going to take him. If the openings are there for him, he's going to take him. We're not going in there to just have a boxing match. So.
Again, when the fight was announced, there was some grumbling on the forums, as there always is when BAMMA announces a fight card for some reason. And some were saying that the place of the fight on the card isn't right because the level of the opponent, and there was some criticism going out. I think not towards you and Matt, but towards BAMMA and where the card. What do you have to say to those people? Do you care?
I don't care, but just to be realistic, I'm a Bellator veteran. I've had a couple of weeks. He's a UFC veteran, fought good guys. He's a world-class wrestler, it's not an easy fight. He could smother me for 15 minutes and win a decision all day long. He could knock me out. Anyone can get knocked out, I don't know what people are moaning about, It's a good fight. It's two veterans. I think it's going to be an entertaining fight. The last fight, the last main event was Jack, but the main event on TV was bloody Alex Reed and Sam Boo, and it wasn't one of the most entertaining fights I've ever seen. No disrespect to the guys, but it was a bit, I think I've been in more entertaining fights, so I'm presuming knocking me out of a shit fight. curse myself, I'm in exciting fights, and I'm pretty confident it's going to be a more exciting fight than that, so I don't know what people are going about.
you know, you talked about Alex Reed, Sam Vu, and this isn't on the card, so just tell me if you don't. But, you know, after the fight with Veach and you win, I think you'd probably be offered the welterweight title shot, because I know this one was supposed to be considered. Would you want that shot, or would you consider stepping up to face the name that is Alex Reed, you're to right, put Jimmy Wallhead? Is that a fight that you would entertain because you have stepped up before?
You know what, I'd probably lie if I said no. Yeah, of course I would, but I'm not calling out Alex. Yeah. I like Alex, yeah, man. Like, I've only met him a handful of times. You know what I mean? I think he's a funny guy. He's a character. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I'm not calling him out. But my manager wants me to stay at Waltway anyway, so he probably won't even let me, if I'm totally honest. He wants me to stick what I'm doing. And if I'm, in all honesty, the thing in my back of my mind is more one day working my way to lightweight. I'm staying at welterweight. I'm not saying I'm going down. I'm staying at welterweight. But if I was going to consider a move again, it'd be the other way. My manager doesn't want me going up and down. He wants me to get strong here and do what I'm doing. But then it'd be, you know, it'd be daft to not have a fight with Alex, because he's such a big shout, you know, for the exposure and stuff. So I don't know, but it's not something I've ever considered, and never going to get a second thought again.
See, if I was sitting next to Rampage now, I'd be slapped.
Is that a slap?
Yeah, that's where I get my slap. Look, I wonder. I know you've had a hard day training. You've just done a two-hour class. But before we let you go, is there anybody that you'd like to thank? Any sponsors you'd like to mention, please?
You know what? Yeah, I'm getting a list out, because I always forget someone and feel guilty for it. Okay, so I'd like to thank my coaches, Owen King and Owen Comrade, Victor Esteem and Mark Jarvis for my conditioning, Graham Ridgeway at QAV for my sponsorship, Lee Livingston, Paul White for my massage treatment, Ben Crook from Blue Nutrition. I'm working with him for this fight, and feeling really energised off the foods I'm eating, and feeling the best way I felt cutting weight. Obviously all my family, Team Roughhouse, my manager Wad, Wayne at Fourth Dimension, and as I said before, QAV, CSS, Coxie Security Company, Multipower Professional, Booster, Vibrant Five Fingers, and Primal Lifestyle. That's everyone. I've not missed anyone out, so no one can get annoyed. That's why I'm carrying my list around.
Thank you so much for your time.
All right, that's no awesome. Problem. Cheers, thank you.